Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Chellin. Now, this question came up in a seminar, and I wish I'd gotten the person's name, because when I came back and tested it, it was really tough for me to duplicate the problem that he said that he had. He had one worksheet here with some data on it, and he was basically using formulas to copy this data to another worksheet. So, here on my secondary worksheet, I have the headings, and basically, you know, to set up a link between one sheet and another, it's fairly easy. Type the equal sign, use the mouse, go back and click on the right cell, and when we copy that across, all of the values come through, except for the frustrating issue of blanks. The blanks come through as zeros all the time, and so this person said that he had rewritten those statements to be an if statement. Equal if is blank, open parenthesis, and then he had his text. If it's blank, he was putting in quote, quote, to make sure that nothing showed up, otherwise he wants the cell. And copy that down. And this is a common trick, but he said the big problem with that is now when he creates formulas that point into those cells, so maybe we'll have a total here, and this total needs to be just Q1 plus Q2. Well, what's going to happen is because there's blanks, we're going to get value errors all the way through. Except for this case where both numbers happen to be numeric, but you're going to have some value numbers show through. And he said, you know, I don't know what to do about this. Well, you know, a couple of things. When I first tried this, I couldn't replicate the problem because I was using the sum function out here, equals sum. I want to sum this cell, E4, and this cell, I4. And the sum function is going to handle this perfectly, converting the labels to zero, and it'll work. So that's one solution. The other solution is we could go backwards just to the original formula. So here we just have the formulas that have lots of zeros filled in. Let's go and set up a custom number format. Format cells, and we'll come to custom, and basically what we want to do is say for positive numbers we want to show zero, a semicolon, for negative numbers we want to show minus and a zero, and then for zero we don't want to show anything. So that last semicolon, we're now in the third zone, the zero zone, and we say we don't show anything for zero. Click OK, and sure enough, that's a very easy way to change all of the zeros to blanks. Well, there you have it. A great way to make sure that those zero cells show up as blanks and still allow the formulas to work. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.